Today we are discussing about the isomorphism and properties of homomorphism. First of all, what is the homomorphism definition? G and G cap B2 groups, a mapping phi from G to G cap is a homomorphism if phi of A dot B is equals to phi of A dot phi of B for all A comma B belongs to G. Left side operation belongs to the capital G, right side operation belongs to the G cap. So, if phi is a homomorphism and phi is 1, 1, it is called phi is monomorphism. If phi is homomorphism and onto, phi is epimorphism. If phi is homomorphism, 1, 1, onto, and 1, 1, and onto, it is called phi is isomorphism. Next definition, automorphism. Here, domain and codomain groups are same. Phi from G to G, it satisfies homomorphism 1, 1 and onto. Then phi is called automorphism. These are the properties of homomorphism. Phi from G to G cap B, A homomorphism and A belongs to G. Then phi of E is equals to E cap, where E and E cap are the identities of G and G cap. Nothing but the identity element of capital G is mapping with identity only of G cap. Phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of A whole to the power of N for all N belongs to Z plus. Hence phi of A inverse is equals to phi of A whole inverse. Third one, if modulus of A is finite, nothing but order of A is finite, then modulus of phi of A divides modulus of A. Already we have discussing about the kernel pi. Here we have to show that it is a subgroup of capital G, same as homomorphic image phi of G is a subgroup of G cap. Proof, let phi from G to G cap be homomorphism and A belongs to G. What is the first one? Identity is mapping with the identity only. So E and E cap are the identities of G and G cap respectively. By the definition of the homomorphism, phi of E dot E is equals to phi of E dot phi of E. LHS is equals to RHS. So phi of E dot E is equals to phi of E. Here E belongs to G, phi of E belongs to G cap. So phi of E is the element of the G cap. G cap is a group. By the identity property, any element multiplying with identity, we get same element. Phi of E dot phi of E is equals to phi of E dot E cap. G and G cap are the groups. It satisfies, every group satisfies cancellation law. By the left cancellation law, phi of E is equals to E cap. What is the second property? Let E belongs to G and phi of E belongs to G cap. What we have to prove that phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of A whole to the power of N for all N belongs to Z plus. By using mathematical induction, we know that what is the mathematical induction for N is equals to 1, for N is equals to K, for N is equals to K plus 1. Here we have to take for N is equals to 2. Phi of A dot A is equals to phi of A dot phi of A. Phi of A square is equals to phi of A whole square. This is true for N is equals to 2. Let us assume that for n is equals to k, that is phi of a to the power of k is equals to phi of a whole to the power of k for k less than n. What we have to prove that for n is equals to k plus 1. Phi of a to the power of k dot a is equals to phi of a to the power of phi of a to the power of k dot phi of a by the group definition. Sorry, by homomorphism definition. Phi of a to the power of k, because phi of a to the power of k is equals to phi of a whole to the power of k dot phi of A. Here bases are same, so add the powers. What is the left side? Phi of A to the power of K plus 1. So for N is equals to 2, for N is equals to K, for N is equals to K plus 1. Thus by mathematical induction, it is true for all N belongs to Z plus. Phi of A to the power of N is equals to phi of A whole to the power of N for all N greater than 1. Also we have proved that phi of A inverse is equals to phi of A whole inverse. For any A belongs to G, since G is a group, it satisfies inverse property. What is the inverse property? A into E, A inverse is equals to A inverse into A is equals to small e. So phi of A into A inverse is equals to phi of A inverse into A is equals to phi of E. By the group homomorphism phi of A inverse, phi of A inverse into phi of A is equals to phi of E. By the first property, what is the first property? Phi of A is equals to E cap. Phi of A into phi of A inverse is equals to E cap. This shows that by the inverse property, The product of the any two elements we get identity. Then so therefore the inverse of the each other. Phi of A whole inverse is equals to phi of A inverse. LHS is equals to RHS. Phi of A inverse is equals to phi of A whole inverse.